And now tonight's Made in Maryland report. A new home improvement shop is offering do-it-yourself classes in everything from plumbing to carpentry. Yolanda Vasquez gives us a hands-on demonstration.
Okay, I'll be the first to admit that I'm not someone who necessarily gravitates towards power tools, but if you are in need of a little help with some home improvement projects, we've got the perfect place for you right here off of Harford Road. It's called Beth's DIY Workshop, and getting a chance to meet Beth Dello. Beth, I'm going to hand this over to you since you know what to do with it more than I do. Pleasure to meet with you.
Good to meet you.
So talk to me a little bit about your workshop. I know you've got something going on right here that we're going to get a chance to look at, but you said this has been a dream of yours for 10 to 15 years.
Oh, yes, definitely. I started in the home improvement business about 32 years ago, and so I've learned on the job and mostly had to teach myself a lot of things along the way, and I just know that people would like to be able to do stuff themselves. And here I am in a city, and a lot of people don't have basements. A lot of people don't have the money to invest in all of these tools, but they watch Norm Abrams on TV and they think, wow, I'd really like to do that.
So this is an opportunity for them to do that.
This is an opportunity to be able to do that.
Absolutely. All right, let's talk about some of the projects you've got going on in this workshop. What's this woman doing over here?
Well, actually, she's doing something unusual. She's cutting corks. She's going to use them on the box that she built in my box making class.
Okay.
And she's going to put them on the roof and paint them to make them look like terracotta.
Wow, that's pretty cool. Okay, and then back over here, we've got some nice little projects going on. This looks like some mosaic tile pieces.
Yes, we had a mosaic class, and we're going to have another one in late January.
Mm-hmm.
And they're just sort of putting the finishing touches on them.
And it starts with this wooden base right there to
design.
Right,
right. They put those out and then build from there. Glue the tiles on, or glass, or ceramic, you know, your broken dishes, bring them in.
Hey, we've got some use for those finally. And then over here we have a young woman who's going to be working on a box.
Right.
Just briefly tell me about what she's going to
do. This is another product of my box class, and she's going to be adding different colored pieces of wood to these, and right now she's going to be cutting slots to put these different colored pieces of wood in, just a decorative part of the
design.
Box.
And last but not least, just so we know, it's not just all women in here.
Right.
We've got our honorary male member over here, Pete. What's he working on?
Well, actually, he's cutting the eye holes in some toys that he's been making on the bandsaw. And I regularly have sort of clinics on the weekends, and, you know, at this point, people are making toys.
Yeah, I was going to say, talk to me about some of the different workshops that you have here that people can learn to do so many different things.
Right, I have home improvement classes, power tools for women, and then I teach basic plumbing, basic electrical, basic how to build a wall, how to hang the drywall, how to finish the drywall, how to fix drywall, all that kind of stuff. And then I'll have ceramic tile classes and how to hang a door, how to fix a door, how to fix a window, all sorts of things. And then we have classes like the box class, so people can get familiar with the shop tools and comfortable with woodworking projects. The box is the basic building block of most wood projects.
And who's been most of your clients? I mean, who are most of the people that come in here? Because we've got a lot of women. Do you have a lot of interest from women who are kind of intimidated by how to use power tools, me number one? I mean, is that what you're getting mostly?
Well, I'm getting women and a few men. So I'm really hoping that it opens up, that we get great diversity here. I want all sorts of people in here working with the tools and learning things.
So what's your hope? Because I know outside of the door you have a nice little slogan that says where imagination and tools meet. What is your long-term goal and hope for Beth's DIY workshop?
Well, that it become a community resource, that folks will feel comfortable coming here to work on their projects. I'll have a welding machine here. I'll have all sorts of things. I want to see inventors in here, you know, making things, recycling things. A lot of the wood that gets used here is just leftovers from various projects that I've worked on, and people bring in their leftover wood. And I'll also have you know, hardware and screws that have collected over the 30 years of work.
Yeah, you've got a big vision for this place, it sounds like. Well, Beth, it was an absolute pleasure speaking with you. We appreciate that. Good meeting you as well. And if you'd like to find out more information about Beth's DIY workshop, just log on to our website at mpt.org and click on Your Money in Business. That's the latest here from Lauraville. Jeff, I'm going to toss it back to you in the studio. And I got to tell you, you're probably a good person to know. So, Beth Dello, good person to know. Back to you.
Thank you.